Hey wizard, let's talk about multiplication and division. At their core, multiplication and division are all about groups. When we multiply, we're making equal groups of a number to get a total. And when we divide, we're taking a total and sorting it into some number of equal groups. The better we understand how multiplication and division can work, the more flexibly we can think about them. We've got these pencils in groups of backpacks here that I've used to represent 12 divided into groups of 3, giving us 4 groups. And groups of 3 pencils times 4 backpacks, giving us 12 pencils. We could switch these two numbers around, making groups of 4 pencils into 3 backpacks, and we would still have 12 pencils. Let's try something a bit different. If I have 5 pencils in a pencil case, 3 pencil cases in each backpack, and 4 backpacks, I can break that up into 5 times 3 equals 15. Then, 15 times 4 equals 60. Just like before, I can switch any of these numbers around and still get 60 pencils. 4 pencils in a case, 5 pencil cases in a backpack, and 3 backpacks. 60 pencils. Okay, one more way we can think of multiplication. I've got 4 times 7 here. I can break 7 up like this into 5 and 2, since they're easier numbers to multiply. Now I can start by multiplying 4 times 5, which looks like this, and gives me 20, and then multiply 4 times 2, which looks like this, and gives me 8. Let's add those products together. 20 plus 8 is 28. 4 times 7 can be broken into 4 times 5, and 4 times 2, which is equal to 28. The more flexibly you can think about multiplication and division, the more ways you'll be able to look at problems and solve them.